that they would, because if they were confident enough to do it on the last drive, starting back up in their own territory, why would you change anything? They've got to be confident about what they're presenting and continue to do so.
Yeah, because the secondary, they really look clueless.
And that was amazing because that drive went and went. No adjustments and no big plays. But
it's caught inside the 25. A pickup there of 37. And it'll be first down, Cowboys. Well, we know he's got the speed there. He needed the speed and the hands. A great catch.
And because of that speed, you have to respect it as a defender. So you have to either play off or make sure you're somehow in contact with him. And he's able to do exactly what you said. Use the speed to his advantage and go up and get the football. That's a big-time play right there.
Now Romo.
Okay, Hunter Bird.
It's incomplete.
All defenders get tired of hearing about their lack of hands and why they're playing defense instead of offense. But in this situation, it was the hands that made the play. Batting the ball away on an attempted touchdown pass. Excellent job. Way to knock it down.
So the incomplete pass brings up second down. They'll come out in the pistol. Romo. And he'll take it into the end zone for a Cowboy touchdown. Cole Beasley. 18-yard touchdown grab. And the Cowboys will extend their lead. And correct me if I'm wrong, that was just a simple fly route, wasn't it?
No, there's nothing to correct at all. You've got it down pat. And I just remember as a player, when I'd be in practice sessions, and I'd hear nine from the receivers, that meant fly route, go, look out. That was the nine, and he just kept going all the way into the end zone for the touchdown.
And it's good to make it 14-0. Kick team out there for the Cowboys as they run up to send this one away. That'll be taken in the end zone. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. And the Cardinals getting set to trot out there now. And with this deficit, you can't have too many more drives like the last drive where you had to punt it away.
You know what I would tell my offense right here? The punter doesn't exist, guys. He doesn't even exist. He's not a team anymore. I just cut him, all right? So you've got to go out and create some offense for us here and give us some points. No way does that guy get on the field on this drive.
Poor punter.
Yeah, it wasn't his fault. But so, hey, listen, there's got to be casualties at times. We're trying to win a game.
A gain of three, second down.
Some of the most unselfish players on any football team, defensive tackles, because we ask them to just eat up blocks, allow other people to make tackles. But when he can make a play himself, as we just saw there, that's a big day.
Get ready! New 95!
Now Palmer to throw on second down. It's complete to Brown, right side. Only 3 yards on the catch. It's third down.
That wasn't even a cover three. You didn't see a cover three.
On third down, the Cowboys bring in an extra defensive back.
It wasn't a cover three. I should have told you what the play was afterwards.
Palmer now. And that is incomplete. Jaren Brown, the intended
You chose
target.
Carson.
And it's fourth down.
I'm not sure we could spot any tendency here on this third down. They could have run it or passed it. Either one was available. They chose to try and get it through the air, but they run successful.
Here comes the Cardinals punter now, as he'll punt it away for the second time.
Oh, get out of there. Get out of there.
And some room to roam now. Touchdown, Cowboys. Their dangerous wide receiver, 69 yards. And the Cowboys will add on to their lead. And we always talk about kick returns being so exciting on kickoffs. Punt return almost equally exciting.
And typically we talk about the kickoff return being the most exciting 10 seconds in football. Let's just cut it in half for a punt return and make it the most exciting 5 seconds in football. It's a great, glamorous, dashing play.
So after surrendering the punt return for a score, let's see what they can do in turn on this kickoff. That's fielded in the end zone. And this return nets positive as he gets past the 25 and up to the 27-yard line. The Cardinals offense now works their way back onto the field. And three and out on the last drive. No points on the scoreboard.
Turn down for what?
Soul searching now?
I would say so. And they need to help out their defense a little bit. They've had to be on the field a lot more than normal. Put them in some tough spots. But what's the old adage? When you get another chance, it gives you a better chance to do it right. Not a run that you're going to write home about, but still a good first down run. That's what an offense calls staying on schedule. 3 to 4 yards on first down, you're set up very well for the rest of the drive.
Get ready.
Out of the gun, Palmer. Over the middle here to Brown. 4 yards on the completion, and it sets up a third down. Well, clearly one of his advantages as a passer is his height. Sit back in the pocket, fired over the middle. That makes things tougher defensively, doesn't it?
It really does, because your goal is to move the quarterback off his initial spot when he gets his drop back completed. But when you have that type of height, he can stay in there. If he's willing to take the hits and just fire over the top, which saves him time, and actually
gets
a little bit quicker than it normally does for.
You bored him playing the game? Huh?
So here we go, first and 10
now.
Am I
boring you because I'm playing the game?
Here we go!
Johnson on the counter. And some room to work. Pass the 20.
Happy Alcoholics
Day. You know this is where it gets tough, right?
For the offense lining up first and 10. Touchdown looked pretty good, so they'd be hoping to do that once more.
And it takes me back to when we sat with the offensive coordinator and the head coach. They felt pretty good about their game plan and thought there were some holes in the defense, and they exploited them the last time out. Let's see if they can come back and put together a similar drive.
And we'll see if they can do just that.
One thing I can say pretty safely, that route is not called if you don't have a guy who can throw the ball and put some mustard on it. Because if you don't lollipop it in the middle of the field, bad things usually happen. It takes a strong-armed guy with the right foot in there, and they were able to successfully complete that one.
Looking deep downfield, and it's caught inside the 30. It's a big play, Romo to Bryan, 52 yards. So after that big play, let's see if they can catch their defense maybe on their heels. Possible run anticipation here as the D-line sandwiches together. A first down carry by Elliott.
Ooh.
And he'll be dropped at the 23.
Okay, no, I tried to truck him.
On the tackle, Tyrann Mathieu.
When you find that kind of yardage, you couldn't be more confident as a ball carrier. And guess what? You go back and tell your offensive coordinator, I'd like to keep carrying it, thank you.
Second down of the offense in search of 6 yards. It's intercepted, picked off by Tony Jefferson, and they get the football, but not much on the return here as he stopped at the 7-yard line. Arizona getting ready to go as they take the field, and the interception thrown in the red zone last time. We'll see if they can rebound.
I just have to think the last thing he said as they went back out there was, don't do that again. What do you think?
What do you think?
Yeah, I think that. I think that not only did he say that, but he also told him, let's put it in the end zone that it's supposed to be in, all right? The end zone we're trying to score. I know we're being a little bit facetious here, but the bottom line is take care of the football, and everything else should flow from there.
Quick lesson, never ask the play-by-play guy a question.
Hey, you're my partner. I know you're right there with me.
Get ready. That's fine.
Now Palmer, down around his goal line. Caught by Nelson, left side. 8 yards on the completion, but now they face third down. And this time they go underneath for a simple pitch and catch.
And not only do you get the pitch and catch, Brandon, but you're able to keep the receiver moving when you hit him with the drag route.
Let's go, let's go. Blue 58. Blue 58.
From the gun on third down, it's Palmer. Caught right side, Jerron Brown. And he will have the first down as he's up to his 17-yard line.
Would it be safe to say that as precise as routes are supposed to be run in the NFL, maybe they're not quite as precise in college ball?
Right,
that's
there,
accurate, yeah.
And I think we saw a college route in the NFL there. Just find the soft spot, find the dead zone, and find the first down. And that's what he just did.
Let's go!
They'll run it now out of the gun. And a short pickup there as he'll take this up to right around the 20. 3 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down.
We always like to talk about defense in terms of levels. First level defensive line, second level linebackers, third level defensive backs. On that run, that was what we call a first level run, and it was stopped by a second level player.
To throw his ball. No, he almost had it. Already with one interception, just missing his second there. Boy, just threw an interception last drive, nearly another pick.
And things aren't very even right now, are they? It's a little bit sloppy out there, isn't it? It's kind of different driving on those paved roads and those country roads that have those potholes in them, isn't it? That's the way this game's going right now. A lot of bouncity bounce to it.
You spent some time on a 50-50 ball here, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Orlando Scandrick. And they are going to set up shot at the 40-yard line. And now Dallas gets set to take the field. Looked like they had something going last drive. Then the interception happened. Will they recover?
The memory they need to keep with them is that they did have something going. They were moving the ball on offense, had a nice sequence going. Don't worry about the other part. You can't get that back. Let's go back to what you were doing well before.
I thought you were going to say they need to have no memory, but remember the good part, forget the bad.
I like that even better.
10 yards still left on second down. They'll run it now out of the gun. Trying to run inside, but nothing there. 1 yard, the official pickup there, so it's going to set up third and nine.
Well, I think we know by now that every run is not going to be broken and get all the way to the end zone. But these short ones still have their value. You can still set up your play action and throw the football. You control the clock because you have the ball and they don't. And often the physicality sets the tempo for the game.
He's going to loft one deep left side here. So they took a shot there on third down, couldn't get it. Now it's four.
Help me out, partner. Was that incomplete?
That was on a deep ball.
They had to give you one back.
The way he attacks the football in the air, it's always surprising to me when he doesn't complete a pass like that.
So possession goes over here on the punt. And the Cards are going to have the football with a first and 10 deep in their own territory.
I think so.
Get ready. Blue 58.
They begin the drive with Johnson. And he'll go down after losing yardage at the 10.
Number one, left defense
in the league. Yard there, and now second down.
When you put together a formula for winning defense, it's exactly what we're seeing in this game. Controlling the line of scrimmage, attacking, and changing everything so that now they're playing in the offense's backfield. They're playing an excellent game.
Throwing is Palmer, surveying the field. This one complete to Jermaine Gresham. And a nice gain of 21 yards. And it looks like this will likely be the last play before we hit the two-minute warning.
Let's see if they can sneak one more good play in before the two-minute signal.
Now Palmer. 1:57 to go in this first half. We're back to Arlington right after this timeout. Offense looking to avoid a third and long. It's 2nd and 10. Second and 10, it's Palmer again. And his throw's going to be incomplete.
He's already fucked up because he's thrown two picks.
And the offense looking to pick up the first down.
So is Mark Sanchez.
Second down incompletion. Now here we go now, an extra defensive back in there on 3rd and 10.
I'm just saying he's an NFL quarterback.
On third down, Palmer. And he's got Gresham. And he's taken down, but not before getting this across midfield and just shy of the 40. And now a timeout called by the Cowboys defense. It's just their first, so they'll have two remaining here before we get to halftime.
I ain't trying to let you score nothing.
On first and 10, it's Palmer. And his throw is going to be incomplete. Second down here after the incomplete pass. Going to be brought down at about the 33-yard line. A nice job to get 8 there after the incompletion, and now they'll look at a 3rd and 2 coming up. Trying to keep the drive going here. This is play number 7 on 3rd and 2.
Let's go! Blue 58!
3rd and 2, now Palmer. Fitzgerald's got it right side. And he's going to have a first down here as he gets this one to the 17-yard line. That one good for 16, and the drive will continue.
Well, there's the first time in this game that Carson Palmer finds Larry Fitzgerald. Likely won't be the last, but how about the way these two have helped each other's career?
Yeah, they really have. It's hard to believe with Fitzgerald, but really both of these guys, how long they've been in the game. Fitzgerald, gosh, third overall pick back in 04.
Yeah, how about that? Remember Carson Palmer, a former Heisman Trophy winner? He's finally found a real home in Arizona.
Second and 10. It's Palmer again. He's got his man. It's caught in the end zone. Touchdown, Arizona. Larry Fitzgerald from 17 yards out. And the Cardinals cut into that lead.
Yeah, you heard it, right? Exhale. The exhale, and I'm taking that from their bench because finally, right before the half, they find a way to get the ball in the end zone and get some points on the board. Maybe they can use that to kickstart them for the second half.
Yeah, just to get something before going into the lockers. And now in the second half, they can just tighten.
It's what they want to do, tighten down everything they're doing, and it maybe explode at the right time.
And out now come the Cowboys. And we'll see how this is played. Offensively, they've got the lead, not a whole lot of time left. What do you think, Charles?
Well, it's tempting to try and add to your lead, but a mistake there, that could change things in a big way. I say go ahead, take the knee, get on out for the half.
Drops it underneath to Elliott. It'll be a gain of 9, and it'll be 2nd and about a yard to go for the first.
So many times you hear today's NFL described as a space game. Get your best players into space with the football in their hands. That's why sometimes you swing it out to your runner, get him out in the flat, and let him have a chance to make people miss an open field.
On 2nd down, here's Romo. And boy, that one drops incomplete, but if he was hit a fraction sooner, it may have been a fumble. They got pressure there and only rushing 3.
And there's a defensive coordinator right now who is celebrating not just getting home with 3 there, but realizing if that's the type of pressure he can get in the entire game, then his pass defense is going to be excellent. You're dropping 8. Where are you going to go with the football?
No, they would have gotten a conversion if he could hold on. Instead, the drop means it'll be 4th down.
We know it's not an easy job to go out and catch passes when people are trying to tackle you and knock the ball away, but the bottom line is, that's a pass he's got to have and a pass he should have caught.
And now on fourth and one, it's a fake.
That's a horrible pass.
This is incomplete. A huge game.
Who do they have throwing? Who do they have throwing the ball?
Now making their way back out onto the field. Last time they were out,
who did they
scored.
Have throwing the ball?
Still trailing here, though, so some work to do.
But it's okay in terms of mindset. Because they scored the last time, they're not quite as worried about being down on the score.
And he'll take this one in for the Arizona touchdown. David Johnson, 30 yards. And the Cardinals get a bit closer.
I think everyone in the league talks about finishing, don't they? Doesn't matter whether it's a quarter, a half, a game, a series, whatever. But they're finishing the first half in fine style, putting that one in the end zone.
They did. They didn't leave much time on the clock either. Well done. Now Catanzaro after the touchdown to kick it away. That'll be taken in the end zone. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. And now Dallas gets set to take the field. And we'll see how this is played. Offensively, they got the lead. Not a whole lot of time left. What do you think, Charles?
Well, it's tempting to try and add to your lead, but a mistake there, that can change things in a big way. I say go ahead, take the knee, get on out for the half.
They go play action here on first down. So they took a shot on first down, but couldn't connect.
Well, partner, I guess that answers the question about whether they're going to sit on it or not.
It does. Now we'll see if they try that again.
Yeah, I think what we find on plays like that, when you take that shot, if you're unsuccessful, then you go way more conservative to finish the half, you know? I think that's the way they'll go.
Now whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense. So that means they're down to one remaining here as we head toward halftime. Romo here on first down. He's got time. He's going to look deep. That's caught inside the 20. Touchdown, Cowboys. Dez Bryant, as the first half is winding down, and the Cowboys will extend their lead.
Heard a coach talk about those late in the half scores, especially ones that give your team a pretty decent cushion. He said those could be the ones that could finish off a squad if you let them.
Yeah, they've got the cushion. This half has been theirs. And, oh, it's no good on the PAT. So they can't add on here. And our score is going to stay right where it is. The kick team out there for the Cowboys as they run up to send this one away. That'll be taken in the end zone. And in hindsight, probably should have stayed where he was, as he'll only get back to the 16-yard line. Arizona getting ready to go as they take the field. And you got to think, if this is anything other than just taking a knee, I'd be very surprised.
Yeah, they've got enough to talk about at the half. Why do anything else? Just get out of there.
It's a 6-yard pickup, and it gets him to second and four. Yeah. Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense. It's just their first, so they'll have two remaining here before we get to halftime.
Who's cheating me?
4 yards remaining. Now hang on here. Timeout called. Timeout called by the defense. And with halftime on the horizon, they'll be out of timeouts from here forward. They come up in an empty set. 4 wide receivers, 1 tight end. They come out 5 wide, 3 of them to the right side. Now Palmer. Palmer's hit. Fumble. He loses the football. So we've hit intermission. It's halftime. This is the NFL, and it's a presentation of EA Sports. So both teams have their marching orders, and we'll get going again here in quarter number 3. That's fielded in the end zone. And he will be brought down here at about the 17-yard line. So here's the Cardinals offense now as they get set to start this third quarter. They have the ball here for the inaugural drive of the second half. Pretty big deficit, though. We'll see what adjustments were made in that locker room.
And I never want to make something more important than it actually is, right? I don't want to create more hype than what is there.
But this
is I'm doing it, though. This is a really important drive. And we often talk about teams scripting plays to start a game. A lot of them script to start the second half, too. And they're scripting something that they expect to get them into the end zone and back into this.
And now this one's intercepted. A third interception for Palmer. Picked off by the linebacker.
Joe Shane, I say thanks.
Now we take a glance at the offense as they work their way back out for their first possession of the second half. And they will simply, Charles, be looking to duplicate what they did last drive when they were able to push it in for six.
And they hope it'll be that easy, right? To be able to take exactly what happened before, replicate it. They have to make a few additional changes along the way because I'm sure the defense will make some adjustments, but they've got to have great confidence having scored the last time out.
Just a yard on the catch there. It'll be second and nine. So they complete the pass, and now they face a second down. Again, we'll see the pistol here. Romo now to throw it. Deep drop. That is caught inside the five. That is into the end zone for a Cowboy touchdown. Terrence Williams, a 22-yard touchdown grab. And the Cowboys use the short field to their advantage as they cash in for six.
God damn, two in a row? Oh.
And it's no good. Oh, he misses the extra point, and our score stays right where it is. Out is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away. That'll be taken in the end zone. And he'll elect not to return this one, so they'll bring it out to the 25 on the touchback. And the Cardinals offense here ready to take over. They trail offense, first time to touch the ball in quarter three, and we'll see what they can do.
And I can't wait to see what they have planned, because some teams script to start a half, other teams just go, okay, these are the sequence of plays we want to run. These things worked well for us. And sometimes they throw in that big chunk play right away.
Shocker.
Try and get after them early and try and create a big play to give themselves some momentum.
See what they have up their sleeve. On second down, here's Palmer. Caught on the left side, Fitzgerald. The ball comes out. It's picked up by the Cowboys. And now here come the Cowboys. And they'll just simply be looking to build off the confidence of the last time out where they scored a touchdown.
And confidence is powerful, isn't it? When you've scored once, you feel like you can go back out there and get it done again. Doesn't matter what the defense throws at them, they feel like they're in a groove right now, and they want to get out there and show it.
Yeah, hoping to stay in that groove here this goal.
Playing again.
Sorry.
fall asleep. Nah, I ain't got it. So I said, you about to fall asleep.
I'm Larry Ridley. You're tuned into the NFL on EA Sports. In today's game, we've got two wide receivers who love to make an impact and be number one receivers. It's DeSean Jackson going up against Dez Bryant. With that, we'll send you out to Arlington, Texas. Here's Brandon Guyton and Charles Davis.
Thank you, Larry. EA Sports coverage of the NFL brings us to the Lone Star State and Mammoth AT&T Stadium in Arlington, Texas. Tonight, we've got a good NFC matchup on tap between the Washington Redskins and the Dallas Cowboys. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. They'll come out in the pistol.
Let's go! Green and 39! Leopard! Leopard! Over!
Again, you'll see the pistol here. On first and 10, Cousins.
Oh, my.
Able to intercept it. That's one he would have liked to have held on to.
Hold on real quick. That's how I probably do.
Here we go now. Green 39. Green 39.
They'll run it now out of the gun.
I don't know how I feel about
it. And they're able to get this one across the 35. A nice pickup there of 11 yards, and it'll move the sticks.
And that's the way to get things started the first time you touch the football on the road. And you have to believe, all week long, all they've talked about is, okay, going into a hostile environment. We're the visiting team. How do we take control of this ball game early? That's one way right there. No fear, guys. And if they had any, it's probably gone after that run.
He couldn't quite hold it. Got hit. Ball pops out. Incomplete. And the defense for the Cowboys.
Sean Lee is a linebacker with an exciting mix of tackling ability and coverage skills.
On second down, Cousins again. And the hit jarred it loose.
He dropped it.
It's incomplete. Yeah. They were trying to get it there to Josh Doctson. And it's third down. Going for the deep ball, and he couldn't hang on to it through the contact. Incomplete.
Well, they went for the big play there, but that drop could really hurt their momentum.
So on fourth down, the Redskins will call on Tressway to punt it away. And here's a very low line drive, almost whiffed on it. That's pulled in at the 32. Only 29 yards on the punt there. Definitely not his best. And the offense will come back onto the field for the first and 10. They'll come out in the pistol. Now a first down throw, Romo. And this one caught by Dez Bryant. And he's taken down, but not before getting this
across
midfield and just shy of the 40.
I can't play with Jim.
And there you go, Tony Romo to Dez Bryant. That often serves as an electrical charge for their offense.
And a warning to the defense, beware.
Yeah, that's the first one of the day. You have to figure there's plenty more to come.
You hold it, man, but I can't play with Jim.
Okay, starting lineup time offensively, Charles, for the Dallas Cowboys.
And how about them at number four in the 2016 draft? Big needs on the defensive line, and they go with the running
back. They go star power.
They went star power, but Ezekiel Elliott, in a lot of ways, was exactly the right decision. When they had winning success in 2014, they did it running the football. Elliott can do that for them again.
Escape and he goes down. That winds up pushing him back 11 yards on the sack. And that'll bring up third. Time in the pocket. He's going to loft one deep into a double team, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Bashaun Breeland. And a big turnover there as his guys will get
the football back.
I'm going to
just call
that
Washington
as they come onto the field.
Just call that an
and last time out, they had to punt the football away. Anything positive possibly to take from that?
When
you're punting the football away, it doesn't sound like it because you're giving it up. But you've avoided a mistake.
At least you didn't turn it over.
You didn't turn it over. Right? You're giving your defense a chance because you're punting the ball away and they're set to go on the field as opposed to sudden change after a turnover. Wow, now we've got to go out there and stop people. So, yeah, there's always something positive to be gained from it.
Again, a run with Thompson. And they'll take him down at the 31-yard line. 2 yards on the pickup there, but it's enough to give him a new set of downs.
Second and one is often an invitation to take the big shot downfield. I'll bet the offensive lineman said, are you kidding? We just get on our backs and let's go get the first down. They love being physical.
Cousins on first down. He sets to fire deep. And it pops free. The collision there jarred the ball loose and brings up second down.
On every offensive coordinator, every play caller sheet, they have about 5 or 6 plays per game that they call shot plays or big plays, and you don't get many opportunities.
Now the hit comes, and Cousins lost the football. So they take over not only in enemy territory, but in the red zone at the 16-yard line. So out come the Cowboys now as their offense gets set to take over. And following the interception, just any interception, are you a little bit more cautious when you start that next drive, or no, you just throw that out the window?
I think you are. I don't think that there's any way you can run back out there and go, totally didn't affect me. Let's just go ahead and be loose with the football again. You're going to take care of it, but you have to be careful about being too cautious because now you can't run any offense at all.
Still want to attack. We'll see how they attack them here. It's a gain of 5 on the play.
I've seen that happen a couple times.
Second down. And here is the Redskins defense.
Trent Murphy's number one attribute is playing against the run, but he continues to work hard on his pass rush skills.
That ain't just the Cowboys.
Here's Romo now on second down. His pass caught in the 4. And he'll take it into the end zone for a Cowboy touchdown. Cole Beasley from 10 yards out.
Yeah, damn,
and the Cowboys have taken the early lead.
That's 3 straight.
And his kick is no good.
Going from last game.
An inauspicious start here, kicking wise. Vision blurred or something. Stays a 6-0 game.
Pull up. So, what should have been a pick?
Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes. That's fielded in the end zone. And he'll elect not to return this one, so they'll bring it out to the 25 on the touchback. Look at Washington as they come onto the field. And last time, not only the turnover, but that turned into 6 points. They got to make up for that here.
We always hear about empty possessions. But some are worse than others. You can have an empty possession, pump the ball away, get yourself set to play defense. But when you turn it over, it changes momentum, and when they take it down.
In a double coverage, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Barry Church. And they will set up shop at their own 46-yard line. The offense for the Cowboys now working their way back onto the field. Here's Romo. He finds his target, Terrence Williams. It's a gain of 17 that time. And that leads to a Dallas first down. And a good quarterback facing zone coverage, if he has just a little bit of time to survey the scene, that's what's going to happen.
No doubt about it. If there's no pressure, he's going to continue to pick them apart because he'll have all that time to find someone open downfield. You can only cover for so long. So maybe they want to go to a zone blitz scheme, get a little bit more pressure. Remember when Carolina did that against Denver? They lost the game ultimately. They dropped the defensive end out, and he ended up with an interception in that game in Super Bowl 50.
And this is caught for a Cowboy touchdown. Dez Bryant, 36 yards. And the Cowboys will add on to their lead. And they use that height on the outside to get the score.
We've seen the evolution of the wide receivers. They've gotten taller and taller, but they retain their quickness and their speed. It's a lethal combination.
Always good to have wide receivers with height. The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. This is fielded a couple yards deep. And a nice return sets him up pretty good here at the 30-yard line. Now the Redskins offense, they get set to go back to work here. And last time, one play interception. So this offense, they should be fresh.
That's a good way of putting it. And I can't wait to see what they decide to do with play calling. Because a one-play drive where you throw an interception, a lot of people think the very next time out, run the football, don't give them a chance.
Maybe play action?
I think maybe you go play action, show your quarterback, get a little confidence in it, and let him fling another one.
And he'll scratch out only about a yard up to the 32. Tyrone Crawford in on the tackle.
That's a good play by the guys on the defensive side of the ball. Held him to a gain of two. And that changes the playbook a little bit now for the guy calling plays. Second and eight. Now he's got to probably think about going to the air instead of maybe staying with the ground game.
See if they stay on the ground for second down. Cousins now on second down. This one caught by Crowder. It goes as a gain of eight, and it moves the chains.
I think that's a big pickup for a first down, because when you run a drag route against zone, you're sometimes asking for trouble because you might run into a defender.
Yeah, well, there they ran into a first down, executed it to perfection.
All right, now, Lucky 56. Lucky 56. Here we go now. Over. Over. Hurry up. Here we go. 3-19.
They run it here with Thompson. And he gets this one to midfield before he's brought down. Give him 10 yards on that one, and that'll earn him a fresh set of downs.
Absolutely love the run right there. This guy's known for his quickness, but also for his speed, and he's able to get to the second level almost before you blink if you give him any type of blocking. Always talk about slot receivers, and they're usually known as quicker than fast. In this case, we've got a guy who's quick and fast, and he used it to great advantage.
And almost intercepted. It would have been his second pick of the game. Instead, it'll be second down.
He's not exactly had a banner start to this game. We're still in the first quarter. He's already thrown an interception, and that should have been the second one.
Offense still needing 10 yards. Second down. Another pistol look here. Cousins now from the 50. And he takes a shot on the release as this will be incomplete. He was trying to find Deshaun Jackson that time. And it's third down.
It's a tried and true formula, and I don't think it'll change for as long as we play football. If someone's trying to throw the ball and you can put pressure on them and make it tough, that's only going to help your defense.
Yeah, he's since being hurried. He got rid of it before taking the hit, but incomplete. On third down, Cousins. This is caught by Jackson, and he gets this one all the way down inside the 20-yard line.
Okay, what can't Deshaun Jackson do? All right, we know about the catches. We just saw another one there. Also gets involved in the return game, and he can break big plays like that. We've seen him do it throughout his NFL career.
We have. What are you thinking of, anything in particular?
Yeah, I'm still remembering a certain Giants punter not following orders, and Deshaun Jackson made that big-time return all the way back for a game winner in that one. I still remember seeing the looks of disbelief on the Giants sideline.
First and goal, Kelly. And he'll take this into the end zone. Touchdown, Washington. A great play there. A 3-yard touchdown run. And the Redskins have made this a one-score game. And that'll make it 13-7. Back live, Charles Davis to my right. I'm Brandon Gauden. It's Redskin football to begin quarter number two, as we'll see one following the score on the final play before break. Here's Hopkins now out to kick it away. This is fielded a couple yards deep. And he'll take it up past the 25 to the 26-yard line. Now the Cowboys offense heads back onto the field. start on the ground with Elliott. They find some open field here. And they're able to get this one across the 35. It's a gain of 11 yards that time, and it produces a new set of downs.
I don't want to downplay the run, but that's exactly what I expected out of him coming out of college. When I look back at my draft analysis, one of the highest-rated players on my board, a three-down back who can do everything. And one of the best parts of his game is what he does when he doesn't have the football, because he carries it really well, but he blocks equally as well as pass protection for his quarterback. I think he's going to be special. All right, I'm going to show my age here a little bit. We used to talk about running backs catching the ball as safety valves. Nowadays, they're a big part of the passing offense.
Quit acting like you're so old. You're only 65.
Here we go.
They fake the give to Elliott. Now Romo going up top. That's caught inside the 20. And he'll be marked down deep in Washington territory. It's a big play. Romo to Bryan. And even 50 yards. And now a first down following that long gain.
Check. Set. Right 18.
Guard.
Left 35. Black 35.
Romo. And that is caught. Touchdown, Cowboys. Jason Witten from 8 yards out. And the Cowboys will extend their lead. What a great weapon. So often, such a big mismatch.
And there's no route he can't run. You name it, he's going to do it. And he's a matchup nightmare for the defense. No matter who they put on him, he's going to win the battle.
The kick team out there for the Cowboys as they run up to send this one away. That'll be taken in the end zone. A look at Washington as they come onto the field. And they're hoping to capture some of that magic they had last time out when they were able to put together a scoring drive. But they're still down here, Charles.
Not the major concern, though, because of what you talked about. They scored the last time out. They feel good about themselves. They feel like their game plan is now in effect. They know how to attack and what plays they want to put together. But they've got to keep it moving in the right direction because, as you did note, they are down on the scoreboard.
And he is met at the line of scrimmage, and he goes down right there. No gain on the play there. Second down.
No gain on that run, and while this team is down, they're not out of it by any stretch of the imagination. Maybe you just have to think about different style of running in order to get this guy going.
And on second and 10 now. They'll put two receivers left, two to the right. Now a second down throw for Cousins. Out to the left, it's complete to Dodson. 6 yards is the pickup, and that'll lead to a third down. Let's see what the defense dials up here. Third and 4.
Green 39! Green 39! Watching that body!
Cousins from the gun on third. And he can't come up with a pick. Nearly his second of the game. Instead, fourth down. Well, they've had a pretty frustrating first half here offensively, and then just continued there with that incompletion.
Yeah, definitely frustrating for them, but heartening for the other guys. Those stop troops, they're enjoying things right now because they've made it very difficult for them throughout the half.
NFL teams last year, a little under 50% on fourth down conversions. This is a bit tougher. Fourth and 4. They'll indeed go for it. It's Cousins. He finds his target. It's Crowder. And they're going to get this one all the way out across the 45. I don't know if I agree with that. I guess they don't care if I agree with that. But, boy, you have to be surprised by that, right?
I definitely was surprised that they decided to go for it in this situation. But they must have either felt like they either had a great play call on or they're trying to show extreme confidence.
Thompson. And he is going to lose yardage here. That's going to go as a loss of a yard, and it'll be second down.
With the struggles we're seeing up front for the offense today, they've got to think about changing up their play calling. Some screens, some draws, some quick hitting plays in order to try and supplement the run game. You don't totally abandon it, but you try and give it a little bit of help.
And the offense behind the chains here, a touch on second and 11. Second down, Cousins. On the catch, it's Crowder. And he's going to get this all the way down inside the 35. A nice gain of 21 yards.
Never make the mistake that the slot receivers, especially the little guys like we're watching here, are just quicker than fast. A lot of them combine quickness and speed, and they catch a lot of footballs, as we just saw there.
The ground, it's Thompson. Works his way inside the 30 on a pickup of four. On the tackle, it's Randy Gregory.
And that's exactly what you want on a first down run. Pick up 5 yards, bring up second and five. The defensive line, they've got to figure out a way to out-leverage the guys up front because the offensive line is winning at the point of attack.
So an entertaining first half, and now we have hit the two-minute warning. Yards left for the offense. It's second down. They'll run with Thompson, and he'll get this one down to about the 27. It'll only be a gain of a yard, and it sets up a third down and four now. And now a timeout called by the Cowboys defense. It's just their first, so they'll have two remaining here before we get to halftime. This will be the eighth play of the drive here. Third and four. Cousins now. Jordan Reed has it. And he's able to pick up the first down before he's tackled right at the 10.
And in a lot of ways, that catch is expected. Red zone presence. And that one was realized there. You've got to find your tight end in that situation.
They'll run it here. And he will maneuver his way down to about the 7. It'll be a 3-yard pickup, and it brings up second and goal. And now the Cowboys are going to call another timeout. So that means they're down to one remaining here as we head toward halftime. And a really long drive here, and it goes on and on. Now they'll run it on the toss. And this is going to result in losing yardage. They're driven back to the 8-yard line. They'll lose a yard that time, and that's going to lead to a third down. An extra defensive back on the field here for third and goal. Third and goal for Cousins. And this is taken in for a Redskins touchdown. Jamison Crowder, a 7-yard touchdown grab. And the Redskins are able to make this a close game again. And it's good. The deficit 6, 20-14. The touchdown, Dustin Hopkins will kick it away. That's fielded in the end zone. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. The Cowboys offense heading back out and ready to go again. First and 10, Romo. his throw incomplete. Well, as we sit on the eve of the playoffs, interesting note, first time since 2003 that both Super Bowl teams from the previous year have not made the playoffs. That leads me to this question. Who's the biggest underachieving team of this season?
Well, I would start with Carolina. They went 15-1 last year, and while they were the runner-ups in the Super Bowl, we fully expected them to make a run back towards it this year. I'd say also, if you stick with that, Arizona, trendy preseason pick. They didn't make the playoffs. And Jacksonville, another trendy pick. They didn't make any move towards being a better football team. On the flip side, on the overside, Miami, they made the playoffs. I think Detroit, Tennessee both made great moves. And how about the Dallas Cowboys? Did anyone expect this season the number one seed in the NFC?
Now Romo, and his throw is incomplete. Position, couldn't hold on, third down.
And when all else fails as a defender, when you're not there in the coverage, your best friend is exactly what we saw there. A big play shot taken by the offense. Unfortunately, it ended in a big drop.
They come out five wide, three of them to the right side. Throwing on third down, Romo. He's going to go up top again. And this is caught. And he is into the end zone for a Cowboy touchdown. Dez Bryant with his second touchdown here in this first half. And the Cowboys will add on to their lead. And the lead is now 13. The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. That'll be taken in the end zone. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. Out comes Washington's offense as they get set to take over here. And what do you think goes on here in this situation? If you got the football, you're trailing, you're back in your own territory with just a little time. Do you try something?
You're thinking about jump-starting your team, right? You just mentioned it. They're down. They're trying to get back into the game. But you got to figure, if something goes wrong, you may have put yourself in a spot where you may not be able to come back in the second half. Managing risk is a big decision here.
Toward the sideline, and look at that catch. Dragging the toes, and that's going to be a first down. Well done.
Let's make this one simple. What a catch, especially the finishing part of getting his feet in bounds, toe tapping, and, of course, foot dragging.
A little tapestry, if you will.
Ooh, I like it.
Cousins now to throw on first down. This one caught by Crowder. No gain there on the completion. Second and 10. Now whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense. It's just their first, so they'll have two remaining here before we get to halftime. Now a second down throw for Cousins. On the catch, it's Crowder. A good gain of 14 there, and it moves the chains.
That looked like a pretty good route combination there, because you've got to find a way to clear the guy running the drag, because when you do, you can just put the ball on it and then let him run.
Yeah, he's got some space. Cousins on first down. Surveying the field. Looking for his tight end read, and it's intercepted. The linebacker, Justin Durant, with a pick. And they take possession of the football and have it at the 36-yard line. Here's the Dallas offense now heading back out onto the field. And with time quickly fading here in the second quarter, not sure how aggressively, offensively they want to play this.
I think we'll find out just how much they trust their guys in this situation if they decide to take a shot.
They'll start the drive with Elliott. And he'll be taken down across the 50 at the 45 in enemy territory. They're going to hurry back to the line now.
He's quite an eyeful, isn't he? Big, strong, physical guy. When he came out of school and I looked at my draft board, I went back through my notes to see how I had him rated. The number two back on my board coming out of college. Why? As I mentioned, big, strong, powerful guy, faster than you would think, and has the ability to catch the football out of the backfield, something that we didn't know he truly possessed. We saw that in the offseason workouts. Now he's putting his running ability to good use in the NFL.
Back to throw, Romo. And he can't hang on. That's definitely going to be one he wishes he had back. Incomplete in the end zone.
One thing I know from experience is that when the deep ball is thrown and you're the defender, you've got to fight that little bit of panic that emerges. You've got to play the ball really well. It's a 50-50 jump ball play. And guess what? They took a shot. How are you going to win it? And in this case, they managed to get it done.
And unable to connect on the long pass. It falls down incomplete. First half in the books. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. And how about this right out of the locker room? An onside kick attempt. And the Cowboys are able to recover. A very interesting call and one that backfires. I know they're losing, Charles, but boy, to start the second half with the onside kick, risky.
Felt like a sense of urgency from their side, coupled with, you and I both know the special teams coordinators, they sell their key plays each and every week to the head coach, don't they? Now I guarantee he's been selling this one. We can get it, coach, we can get it. And that came together with that sense of urgency you talked about.
Second half starts with a carry by Elliott. And he's going to be met at the line of scrimmage and taken down. Officially no gain on the play, and it's second down. Off the corner, where'd he come from? Well, I guess he came off the corner, but really nice play.
I like when you're able to pose a question and answer it at the same time. That's exactly where he came from, but it's not something that you normally see. Most of the time, we're thinking about those guys covering pass catchers. In this case, he's a big factor in a run game. No gain.
He's going to float this one deep right side. And they went for a big play through the air on second down. Couldn't connect. Now it's third.
I guess they figure with a guy who is that hot downfield, who knows how to get the ball into the end zone, you throw it up and give him every opportunity, even though that one fell incomplete.
Yeah, he's already been in the end zone multiple times, tried to target him again deep there, but unsuccessful. Defense has set themselves up nicely. Third and 10 now. Romo now to throw. And this is, oh my goodness, he pulled it in one-handed. A really good pickup of 28 yards.
Well, it may seem like an every game occurrence. Let's not treat it that way. Tony Romo's had some injury issues, right? He's starting to advance in years. To watch what he and Dez Bryant did in this game, yeah, that's a lot of fun.
Yeah, when they do that,
oh, wrong button. Wrong button. That was good
connections, which means big-time offense, which usually leads to
big-time defense. I was definitely
the numbers have been good in the passing game, and certainly a big reason why they have the lead. But now here, third quarter, maybe go to the run game a little more?
Yeah, perhaps. I mean, after that incompletion, a little credit to the defense for shutting them down on that play. Maybe you try and run the football a little bit more in this spot. That's still good.
And he'll take it into the end zone for a Cowboy touchdown. Ezekiel Elliott, a 12-yard touchdown grab. And the Cowboys will extend their lead. There are several elements to a well-executed screen pass. This one resulted in a touchdown. It had all of those elements.
Hey, you're so right, because you really need the rush to almost...
Looking for his tight end, Witten, and it's intercepted. Picked off. Dante Whitner, and a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. The kick team out there for the Cowboys as they run up to send this one away. That's fielded in the end zone, and no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. So now we look at the Redskins offense getting ready for their first possession of the second half. They're down in this game. A chance for the offense, though, to put something on the board, get some momentum here at half two.
Try and get things kick-started for them. And you know at the half, they discussed how they were going to get that done. This is where scripting comes into play a lot of the time.
How many plays do you script coming out of the second?
Most of the time in the first half, you're scripting 12 to 16. I think in the second half, you're really scripting more like 8 to 10, kind of a starter or an opener, whatever terminology they use, to something to get you off to a quick start.
So second and 10 here. They'll put two receivers left, two to the right. Cousins now on second down. Out to the left, it's complete to Daxon. That catch good for five. It's third down. Still in search of the first down after that last completion.
Hurry up, here we go. Blue 90.
Cousins from the gun on third. And this is going to be incomplete. He was looking for Jamison Crowder there. And that brings up fourth down. Off the field, they're going on fourth and five.
Set, blue 90.
On fourth down, they do snap it to Cousins. And for a third time tonight, he's intercepted. The linebacker, Justin Durant, with a pick. And he's going to take this one back to the 37-yard line. Now Dallas gets set to take the field. They'll start this drive with very good field position. After the interception, here's Romo. Man open left side, it's Williams. Touchdown, Cowboys! Terrence Williams, 37 yards. And the Cowboys turn that interception into a touchdown. Great corner route there, not only able to catch it, turn it upfield, and get into the end zone.
It usually involves a little bit of an extra move, doesn't it? You've got to get them thinking that you're moving to the middle of the field and you're breaking away to that corner. Boy, that was well executed.
And that will bump the lead up to 26. Out is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away. That'll be taken in the end zone. And he'll probably wish he reconsidered here. It'll cost him 10 yards now with a new rule as he's down at the 15-yard line. So out now come the Redskins. And following the interception, we'll see what they can put together on this drive.
I hear my old college coach right now. He always used to tell us before every game, the team making the fewest mistakes will win. What they're hoping is that last mistake is their only one of the game.
Coaches, that's all they talk about, turnovers, right?
Minimizing those and maximizing opportunities.
It's a loss of a yard there, and now second down.
We just saw another example of how the defense is winning this game. Really, at the point of attack, the offensive line's just getting pushed around. I think now as a play caller, you've got to give them a little bit of help. Maybe keep your tight ends a little bit more. Maybe the running backs help you a little bit with the pass blocking. But you've got to help them get some confidence because you can't abandon the play calling right now.
Right side caught by Jackson. And he's going to get this one across the 30-yard line. He goes for 18 there as the drive will continue.
It's a nice completion, a little bit of run after catch as well to create the yardage that they got. But it is so tough to cover that route, the drag route, because they run it at varying speeds. Because the key is to create hesitancy on the defender's part.
Always so empathetic. And no escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack. David Irving in there to drop him. And it'll be a loss of about 8. Now a second down throw for Cousins. And incomplete there. A nice hit. Jars the ball free and brings up third down.
It looked like they had something there, but I think that he was thinking about running with the football before he actually hauled it in, and that led to a big drop.
And some secondary help here for the defense in the nickel on third and long. Third and long for Cousins. He's got time. Bringing it in, Jackson left side. 14 yards is the pickup there, but it'll still lead to a fourth down.
They didn't get the first down, but I have to say I do like the call. I like what they were trying to do. Try and hit your receiver on the run and see if he can pick it up. Keep it on his feet, get a little rack yardage.
Yeah, but a nice job defensively to get to him and keep him short of the first.
Here we go. Green throw.
They'll indeed go for it. It's Cousins looking for his running back, and he's got it. So certainly an interesting call there to go for it. And Dallas, they'll take over in terrific field position. And now Dallas gets set to take the field. And they were able to punch it in the end zone last time. They'll be looking to do that again here for the defense. Obviously, they'll be looking to stop them from punching it back in the end zone.
It always is punch-counter-punch, isn't it? And which team has the advantage? Well, let's just go back. Last time on offense, they rolled downfield, got into a good rhythm. You can see a little more bounce in and out of the huddle. You can see the sideline really get into the game. So defensively, you're thinking to yourself, how do we take that away from them? How do we get the advantage back? Let's see what they come up with. I think pressure is always the first way to go.
You love pressure.
I love it.
We'll see if they dial it up this drive.
Whenever I see a drop like that, I have to kind of take a step back and check myself a little bit. So used to seeing those big guys make big-time spectacular plays that when they drop one, I have to remind myself, we have to...
Now Romo hit, and he loses the football. He had it jarred out, and they will take over possession of the football at their 42-yard line. A look at Washington as they come onto the field. And this offense last time turned it over, went four on fourth, didn't get it. They're lucky, though, because no points against the team on the board, but we'll see how they respond.
Yeah, they've got to get a lot of credit to their defensive teammates, don't they? They had their backs on that last series, and because they did so, that allows the coach to still stay aggressive on offense and maybe go for it again in a similar situation.
I was going to say, maybe makes that offense feel good, but when you know you've got a defense making stands like that.
Yeah, that'll loosen up things a little bit, won't it? Maybe you'll play a little bit better the next time you have the ball.
One receiver left, three to the right.
Here we go.
A first down throw for Cousins. And the tip there altered the ball flight, and it falls incomplete. It'll be second down. So incomplete on first. Let's see what second down has in store.
Let's go! 3-19! 3-19!
A second down throw for Cousins. He's going to air one out. And the hit jarred it loose. It's incomplete. Pierre Garçon, the intended receiver. And now it's third down.
Looked like they had an opportunity for a big play across the middle, but he didn't have the concentration or the focus necessary and dropped it before he could haul it in.
10 yards to go on third. And incomplete. The contact made the ball roam free and brings up fourth down.
On any passes in the middle of the field, anyone who's going after the football is going to be conscious that it's probably going to be contested and often physically.
He looks just like that, man.
To drops.
Still just going. Ain't going in, she can't get that. Oh, that's tough as shit.
Team out there for the Cowboys as they run up to send this one away.
I'm bringing that shit to Mall.
That'll be taken in the end zone.
You gonna be in the crib? Ooh! How did he get that back? I just smacked him. Yeah, I did.
So they will get the ball after all, but that could have been a disaster.
Wow, I agree. All right,
that's a bet.
That's a fumble.
On the hit, but they'll say it's incomplete.
When defenses get to the quarterback that quickly, a lot of times it's called a jailbreak. It wasn't quite that fast, but fast enough that he had no time to look downfield and set himself to throw the ball. And as he tried to do that, he was hit.
They'll put two receivers left.
You want to try something? On the count of three. Let's say what we're about to do. I mean, unless you don't want to.
No, I'm not afraid to say it.
Okay.
All right, ready?
One, two, three.
Alligators. That's really similar for me. Like, for real.
Okay.
But when you can pick it up in big chunks and strike like that, have explosive plays, that's often the difference in one two, three.
I'm afraid that I'm going to make so much advantage. Did you lose weight to gain self-confidence?
I think I lost the weight so I can gain a better view of my perfect penis.
Ah! This little guy. That's some real shit.
Medium. Place the medium guy. You are so not boring, by the way.
You've already fixed so many things. There used to be so much stuff here. Was that a community or
something? Well, a house is just a building. Home is a feeling.
That's beautiful.
Thank you.
Who said that?
I did. Just now.
That failing attack on the extra point. And this one was over a mile ago. As he
were you
shotgunning me? Oh, sorry. Oh, I'm
just shotgunning. It's
my fault. I was showboating. I'm so sorry.
He is fucked up.
Why don't you stick your head over your head again and make Scarface?
Scarface?
Yes! That's who I was the whole fucking time!
That's awesome.
Gotta run it a little less.
I can feel my hair growing!
What?
Oh, I love this song. I gotta dance. Here we go.
Oh, this is your thing.
Who, me or Eric?
Eric.
Does everybody dance delicate?
What?
Is she just...
Yeah, I love
her. Yeah.
Oh, shit.
Oh, my God.
Did she just fall through the...
That's how you know it's a real party.
Right. I see some shit like that at the party. Oh, man.
I be blown. Yeah, you didn't see that nigga?
No.
Yo.
That's the nigga who's tripping?
Yeah.
Hey, dude, what is wrong? Hey, I'd be partying with him all night. How'd she get back in? You should pass out by now. Oh, what the fuck? Oh, man, he about to be up all night. He did say Adderall. That shit keep a nigga up.
Yeah, I
want to
try that.
What, the shit that he did?
Yeah, mommy and
Adderall. Oh, no, that's too much.
Just to tell, but okay. That's my Adderall. And we're only meeting. Could
you headline news it for me?
We are
going
to give you 50% of the money from the sale of the house, and then we're going to use the other 50% to pay off the condo.
Then we're leaving more of the stocks.
You could use the money to buy a little house here in
Peru.
Would I have to pay the money back, or would it be more of a wink, wink loan?
We're giving it
to you for free. That's lovely. Solves a lot of things. I gotta go now. Thanks so much. Watching Dragon Teacup teacups. We're very happy for you, honey. Okay, thanks. Bye.
Thank you.
entertainment. Hey, I like that you know who you are, and then you ask who you are. And if you're
you. Thank you.
I just fucked up.
Fingers crossed, you picked a very great question, and I salute you. But you know what? This is how I salute you. Like this. I'm sorry.
That didn't happen. Nobody's
got it. Yeah, I got this. I got this.
What are you writing down?
No, it's my pen.
Here, I have something you should write down. E-A-T. S-H-I-T.
Okay, my sister is clearly riding the ditch at this late hour.
Can you shut this shit down?
Was that Maura Ellis?
Yeah.
She went to the sophomore formal with my cousin who has spina bifida.
Of course she did!
She is a lovely person. He still talks about it.
Yeah.
You know what? You guys enjoy your party.
No. No, no, wait! There's a drunk blind guy swinging a gun around!
In the way. Enjoy! Good. I think you're all set. I'm gonna have to come back tomorrow and finish this because I am drunk.
Well, I'm totally sober, so.
Yeah, I did everyone.
You're very tall. How tall are you?
About 6'3", with a ladder about 7'6".
Thanks so much for cleaning this all up.
Oh, yeah.
Do you want to keep working off the clock?
Yeah.
Because my bed is broken.
I'm going to fix it.
Yeah, lock the door. Shaking and wiggling. Oh, people! I'm in charge here, and I say so. We had a great time.
Did he, Wrap it up.
We have some real buffet. Some perfume is on
you. You like that? It's Risky by Jennifer Love Hewitt. You can only get it at Kohl's.
What?
I'm wearing the red shirt. It's like Calvin Klein.
What did I ever do to you to make you a poor me go? Seriously, you probably don't remember.
Oh, I remember. We were about to have the best Ellis Island party ever because my cousin met John Stamos at Disney and he was coming. But you narked to your cop dad.
I narked because he made me.
I found out that I wasn't invited to your party, it hurt me so very deep that I threw up really hard. Why didn't you invite me? I was kind and clean, and I got both of these.
I know, but you loved me.
And then you decided that I was a no. And then everybody decided that I was a no.
Yes, you decided that I was a no. The bachelor? Me. So I decided that tonight, I deserve to be here.
Tonight, I am a yes. I am a hell yes.
Oh, I am a yeah. I am a hell yeah.
I am a fuck to the yeah.
Wordsmith.
I am a you think I hear yes.
You know what the saddest part is? Your vagina? No. The saddest part is that you and I used to have a blast in grade school. And we would probably still be friends. You weren't such a selfish hothead.
I am not a selfish hothead!
What the hell? Give me that phone! I'm sorry.
Hi, honey. Hi, Mom. I'm here.
I'm Graham and Graham.
You're here? In Orlando?
Yeah.
Oh, great. Okay. You told me that you're gonna help us get a house.
Do you want to come down there and we can talk about it?
We're all pretty wiped from packing. You know, I would say maybe just get some rest and come over in the morning.
Wait, you want me to come there in the morning? You have been begging me for weeks to tell you where I am, and now that I'm here, you're gonna blow me off?
No, I'm not blowing you off. I'm so excited. We're getting a house and you're gonna have your own room.
I got a baloney dick.
Who has a baloney dick?
No. Are you at a party right now?
Earlier, we had a packing cookout.
Cookout? With your cock out.
I'm on the phone.
You say that you want a fresh start, and everyone is trying to help us out.
And this is how you think, Therapy is not what you think.
No, it's exactly what I think.
I start trusting you again, and then you turn around and you start acting like one of the Real Housewives of Orange County.
Can you just give me a chance to make it right?
No, I don't want to live with my loser mom who parties.
You know what? Tonight, I'm actually the only person who's not partying.
Yeah, right.
Intercepted, but they'll say, oh, God, so very good.
you need your hug.
Come on, baby. Oh, look at you.
People are really working their shit out of this game. This is like Korean drama.
First time?
Okay.
I'm just gonna roll you over so we can examine your rectum.
Stop saying rectum.
I'm gonna get it out, whatever it is.